lives on foreign shores, cherishes within her an intrinsic part of the immortal Varanasi soul, rediscovers the essence of that soul.
I'm Noin Thara. We live in Chicago. I belong to a Bengali family settled on the Ganges in Banaras. My link with my soil is in that Banarasi sari, which both my mother and I wore at our weddings.
Mingled in the miasma of her memories, their nostalgia, their fragrance beckoning her back to the ghats of the Ganga, to Banaras once more.
I now want to share this connection with my daughter, Nia. This Christmas, I promise Nia to take her to Banaras and share with her this rich textile tradition, which I hope will be preserved for all times to come.
Day breaks in Banaras, and its first blush illumines the eternal ghats that have defied time. Its faint rays add a rosy incandescence to the lotus-like bodies of the bathers frolicking below, and the river of life's caressing flow. Her immaculate beauty is all aglow. The Ganga swirls in the palm of her hand as she raises obeisance to the sun. The shops come alive with yellow flowers, and the streets wake up with the clamor and toil of the day. In this ageless land of the weavers, this land of artisans, whose delicate dexterity have woven miracles over decades of design.
Tipu Sultan, in the 17th century, gave silk a very special impetus, and to this day, Karnataka produces 70% of India's silks.
In every exquisite creation, has their skill spun sheer magic, and magical is their every creation.
उससे पहले से ये सब आया है हमारे बाप दादा करते थे 15 वर्ष की मेरी उम्र थी ये सब मैंने संभाला आग से देखा फिर यही काम करते रहे चलता रहा आज इतनी उम्र हुई कर नहीं पाता बस बैठ जाता हूँ देखने के लिए इसको गरी बोलते इसको सिरकी बोलते इसको फेंका इधर रोक लिया इधर से फेंका इधर रोक दिया दूसरे इधर रख दिया नीचे बोले करते इसको इधर रख दिया इधर से पकड़ा इसको इधर से इधर काढ़ा फिर इसको पकड़ा इसी में कारीगरी आ जाएगी तब फिर लड़की कहा पहले इसकी कारीगरी बाद में लड़की पहले फाका बनता है फिर मशीन पर जखाट तब तब उठता है उठने के बाद क्या ही होता है तब इसी से तब इसी से काढ़ा जाता है तब इसे उठा करके इसे पहना करके इसको से ऐसे पकड़े रहते हैं पकड़े बनारसी पुराना ऑरिजिनल ओरिजिनल काम
The chosen motifs arrive from the textile designer and are drawn carefully on the graph paper in the colors indicated. The pattern is then meticulously punched by hand or machine into the jacquard loom, and according to each square Off the graph, the card is punched.
ये देखो जैकेट वाला पत्ता है लेस नहीं लेस का डिजाइन है इसको लेस बोलते हैं और ये चलता रहता है
The cards are arranged according to the design and placed in the loom. From here, the warp and weft deftly pick. Every detail of the design, weaving it into silk fabric, thread by thread. Zari work begins first with the hammering of slender silver rods, 1 ounce of silver into 3,000 yards of fine silver rods. Next comes the flattening of the rod so that the badla is produced. This can be used as rupari or coated with 24 karat gold in the finest wire form for the asli zari work. Very often, an imitation copper wire base is used to reduce the cost. The embroidery or the relief effect of the motifs in rupari or suneri is called kalabattu, kacho, titora, kamdani, sitare. The variety is fascinating and the nimble skills exist.
Your deft hands decorate every inch of an archer, and the shining stars they weave laugh on lustrously. While the embers tug at the heartstrings and set the oft-walked streets aglow, yet when the sheen of these stars turn into moist memory, then Varanasi beckons, and people return from the realms across the seven seas, from those faraway foreign shores. She is one amongst those who return, she who cherishes her past, walking these lanes with her future, as she clutches her daughter's little palm, acquainting her with Banaras's mesmeric charms. She anoints her little girl with lessons in a tremulous tehzeeb, a priceless legacy, where both temple bells and azans echo. The conch shell resonates with every stride, while the soul says Bismillah with the shehnai.
Design introduction. Gujarat से अहमदाबाद और सूरत के नवाबों के उस समय के पीरियड में आज से 500 साल पहले वहाँ से डिजाइनर और ईरान के वीवर कहीं कहीं आकर के बैठे तो वो बनती थी 200-300 साल पहले तो वहाँ के कुछ लोग यहाँ आए और डिज़ाइन इनोवेशन का काम रिकॉर्ड में आने लगा धीरे धीरे शुरू हुई इधर से अवध जामदानी शुरू हुई उस पीरियड में नवाबों के पीरियड में और यहाँ जैसे कॉटन की चीज़ें यहाँ बनारस में बनने लगी और कॉटन पे डिज़ाइन डेवलपमेंट होने लगा जो आप फॉर्म देख रहे हैं आज डिज़ाइन का जकार्ड मशीन से पहले प्लेन पे कुछ जामदानी होती थी फिर उसके बाद गेठुआ आया
The silk arrives with a stiff and protective starch coating and must be first degummed by soaking in water and alkaline soap at 95 degrees centigrade to get rid of the sericin gum and be readied for dyeing. arrive at the right shade, we need a special blend of colors. An eye for the right color and the correct choice of the color. Is essential to weave an exquisite Banarasi sari.
In the hands of the weaver is the destiny of each sari cast, and the destined wearer woven in its warp and weft. In the sindoori red Banarasi is the resplendent goddess Ma Durga dressed, while the pure white Banarasi adorns the pristine figure of the goddess Saraswati. And encircling the waist of Draupadi's beatific form, that famed purple Banarasi whose endless silken yards could not be drawn. The attire of the nubile Nujahan did it embellish, and the Banarasi Orni did the lovelorn Umrao cherish. Their footsteps still fan the air, and their graceful figures still inspire the artistry and the work of the weavers here. The luster of their artisanry lights the lamps at dusk, and it is this luminescence that pervades the universe. When these design-bound stars open their lustrous eyes, and those myriad motifs, those beauteous bell booties, speak in the rainbow hues of silk, they exclaim, "This is not merely the world of warp and weft. No, it is a world unto itself. Yes, it is a world unto itself. It is wrought by the blood, toil and tears of 1,000 artisans, whose craft bring alive each woven flower. Let this labor of love, this legacy of the Varanasi weave, never die, my friends." Let the dying rays of the sun never set on this our living heritage. May old traditions meld seamlessly with the new, and this timeless craft be revived anew, etched as it is in the blood of our artisan brothers. To cherish it, it is the priceless treasure of time bestowed upon us. To preserve it, these are the treasures of time that have rolled. Let us now preserve it.